the visiting Commerce University Valkyries and your Flagler College Saints. At this time, we ask that you please turn your attention to the scorer's table and welcome a member from Commerce and Flagler for the reading of today's game announcement statement. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, would you please rise to honor America and those who serve to protect it with the singing of our national anthem, performed for you today by Flagler College student Sarah Presentelli.
The Flagler volleyball team looks for its first win of the season, and the Saints will get plenty of chances this weekend. Four teams visit St. Augustine for the Flagler Saints Classic. Each team plays four matches over 2 days. First up for Flagler, the Converse Valkyries. Saints volleyball starts now. Hi, everyone. Dave Wendell along the way here on the Peach Belt Conference Network. Saints 0-3 after playing in a tournament in Lakeland, the Florida Southern Tournament, and looking to get on track here at home in the friendly confines of Flagler Gym. Let's look at the starters for this afternoon's match, starting with the Valkyries of Converse University. At setter, number 2, Madison Gregory. On the outside, number 6, Ariel Bryant. Also on the outside, number 8, Tia Grappato. On the right side, number 11, A.C. Garbade. In the middle, number 12, Alea Robinson. And in the middle, number 24, Tori Barr. Those are the starters for the Valkyries and head coach Alexis Ivy in her second season in Spartanburg. And now the starters for the Flagler Saints. In the middle, number 6, Colby Stemkowski. On the outside, number 9, Audrey Simmons. In the middle, number 12, Molly Boyd. At outside hitter, number 13, Jordan Berglund. At setter, number 21, Lainey Mack. And at outside hitter, number 24, Cassidy Bloom. Saints are coached by Skylar Lopez. In his second year, the assistants are Matt Girard, Pete Sproles, Tara Zavisky, and Nick Sharonis. Well, both teams looking for their first win of the season. Flagler in their home red over black on the right side of the court. And Converse in the all purple with the white lettering and white numerals on the left side. Well, it should be an interesting tournament. Some good teams are here this weekend, including Embry-Riddle, the longtime Saints rival from just down the road in Daytona, a member of the Sunshine State Conference, very competitive volleyball conference. Also, Missouri Southern is here. And nationally ranked Missouri St. Louis has made the trip down to the ancient city for the Saints Classic. Still introducing the starters. I'm sorry, our camera does not go any wider, but the Saints are off to the right of your picture. And we're just about ready to get this thing started here from Flagler Gym. The Saints play this match, and then they'll be back in action in the night camp around 7, although these tournaments tend to run a little long. So maybe more like 7:30. Just keep an eye on the live stats on the Flagler College Athletics website. That's flaglerathletics.com. Saints used to host two tournaments a year in back-to-back weekends to open the season. Now just one tournament, at least here in 2023. It's a lot to put on this tournament, welcoming in four visiting teams and all the logistics that entails. There's a lot of officials to coordinate and practice schedules and that type of thing. So now just one tournament, at least for this season. And just about to get underway here. Just a few minutes late, scheduled for 1 o'clock. It's 1:08. Saints last year were 20-10 overall, 9-6 in the PVC. They won the conference tournament championship. They were third in the regular season in the PBC. And the first serve of the match will be the setter, Lainey Mack. And the block put up. Berglund and Boyd teaming up. Good start for the Saints. Lainey Mack, one of the new setters for Flagler, along with Amelia Fitzpatrick. And Cameron Fenner still on the roster. She'll get some action at the setter position. She's also a serving specialist. Mack sets up Berglund, and Berglund rips one home. The Berglund Express, we expect to see a lot more of that as we have in the last two seasons. Berglund, a two-time first-team All-PBC pick, also two-time All-Southeast Regional honorable mention. That's off the block and out, and a side out registered by Rapato, the junior from Tulsa, transfer from Southwest Baptist. Rapato will drop to serve for the Valkyries. And the Saints get the serve right back, leading 3-1 early. Berglund with the honors. It's a service error. Berglund picked to the preseason all-conference team. Flagler picked by the coaches to finish second. Just five teams left in the PBC playing volleyball, and Berglund mishandles that. It's an ace for the Valkyries. And Mackenzie Day. Edie Lamoureux has checked in at libero, and she handles that serve. There is Bob Boyd through the middle. Molly Boyd has had a great start to 2023. Boyd is first in the conference in blocks per set, third in hitting percentage, as you'd expect from a middle hitter. Lamro keeps it alive. Off speed, now Lamro will set things up. Bump set, and putting it down is another of the newcomers, Cassidy Bloom, a transfer from the University of Albany. Played 14 matches for Albany a season ago. Lamro to serve, one of the better servers on the roster. And Valkyrie's having trouble handling this. It'll be a free ball. Mack back set for Audrey Simmons, and Simmons puts it away. Simmons, the junior from New Hampshire, transfer from St. Anselm College. Played here a season ago. Saints have lost a lot of production from the roster from last season. There's through the middle it goes for the Valkyries. Another attack, and it's put down by the Saints block. Simmons teaming up with Stempkowski. Saints by four early. Overpass, and another free ball coming for the Saints. Mack lines it up, a little bit of off-balance swing from Stempkowski, and that one's dinked in and it catches the line. Ricardo Cruz is our referee one. Robert Miller is our referee two. Another attack from Stempkowski, dug out by the Valkyries. They'll go to the outside, and that's going to be a kill for Bloom. Substitutes coming in for the Saints, including Amelia Fitzpatrick, number zero. And Meredith Dixon, number 24. The Saints going fairly deep into the roster early in this first set. Dink attempt is denied. And that's Dixon and Stempkowski teaming up. This is Fitzpatrick serving. She's essentially been the number two setter early in the season for the Saints. Of course, gone is Kennedy Muff, one of the all-time greats. That one is in. A nice cross-court attack from Dixon. And a timeout. Full step aside as well. Saints lead it 10-4. Division II's year-long 50th anniversary celebration includes commemorative scholarship opportunities for student athletes who exhibit the core values of Division II, as well as the 50th anniversary gold award given to two deserving individuals who have made a positive impact in Division II. Happy anniversary, D2. Let's make it yours. Saints serving, and another attack through the middle. And that's Demkowski again. Dug out by Lamoureux. Spectacular. Joust at the net. Saints keep it alive on their side. Bloom with a big swing. Into the rafters it goes. Another free ball coming. Through the middle. Good defense by Converse. And they can't get it back over. And it's another point for the Saints, who have opened up an 8-point lead. Fitzpatrick continues with the serve. Big jump serve. And the slide attack from the Valkyries. Putting it down is Robertson, freshman out of Clayton, North Carolina. Converse University, if you're unfamiliar, is in Spartanburg, South Carolina. It's been around since 1889. That serve is out. Service error from Jasmine Hamilton. Head coach of the Valkyries is Alexis Ivy in her second season. She played at Lenoir Ryan, coached at the junior college level, was an assistant at Greensboro College. Bump set for Berglund, and she missed it. Might have thrown off the timing a little bit. Fitzpatrick had to go a long way to get to that ball to set it. Here's Roberts. Overpass from the Saints. And a big finish from Dixon. Dixon, a transfer from the University of New Hampshire. Trying to fill the shoes of Logan Garcia in the middle. Another longtime, highly decorated Saint who wrapped up her eligibility a season ago. Berglund off the net cord, and she registers another kill. That's two kills for Berglund so far. And they'll joust at the net. And it's won by Flagler and Dixon. Stemkowski serving. Long cross-court set. And putting it home is Grappato to give the Valkyries the side out. Gregory checks back in to serve for Converse. Berglund, and Boyd cleans it up. Checking in for Flagler is number 10, Jordan Norwood, the junior from Friendswood, Texas. Speaking of Boyd, she had 11 kills and hit a robust 476 against Washburn back on September 1st. Cross-court set for Berglund, and very little resistance. A timeout taken by the Valkyries. Saints in control, 18-7. time back at Flagler Gym. Saints lead it by 9, 18-7. Haney Mack will serve. Berglund sends it long. Now, we talked about the loss of some key players. Logan Garcia, Annie Bart, Ariana Lopez, but maybe the biggest blow was Kennedy Muff, who, despite playing four seasons, had another season left because of the COVID rules. And she elected to play her final season of eligibility at the D1 level, going from a Division II power of Flagler to a perennial D1 power in Florida, the University of Florida Gators, who are always in the hunt for SEC championships and national championships. She's mainly been the backup setter for the Gators as they returned an all-SEC performer, in fact, the SEC Freshman of the Year. So Moff, as good as she was here, is still looking for some meaningful playing time with the Gators, but is every bit good enough to play at the Division I level, and she's testing that this fall. There's a block that goes out of bounds off the hand of Boyd. My fourth all-time in assists here at Flagler, and she could have perhaps challenged Tara Savisky, who is an assistant here now, although she would have had to have a monster year. Savisky put up huge numbers. Savisky has 4,855 assists, 10.53 a set, and Muff second in assists per set at 9.35, but was more than 1,000 sets or assists behind Savisky, so it would have taken a monster year again. Two of the greatest to ever play here at Flagler just in the last few years, and it's nice to see Savisky helping out at her alma mater. Here's Edie Lamoureux, Saints up by 10, and that one sails long. So one of the few things you could look for in terms of improvement is just a couple of service errors so far. Jordan Norwood puts one away. Saints 3 points away from this first set. The Valkyries have yet to win a set this season. They've been swept in their three matches. Flagler lost to number 17 Washburn in 5, number 6 Barry in 4 sets, as the Valkyries pick up a point. And they lost to Florida Southern in that Florida Southern tournament last weekend in 4. Here's Jasmine Hamilton serving for the Valkyries. And another big finish. I believe that was Dixon. Dixon with 3 kills in this first set. And Bloom will do the serving. That one is out and no touch. Sending it wide was Robertson. And it's set point for the Saints. And an ace will finish it from Bloom, 25-12. The opening tally as the Saints take set number 1 here on the Peach Belt Conference Network. And welcome back. Flagler takes the first set, 25-12. Teams have switched ends of the court. Looking at some first half stats, Flagler hit an outstanding 444 in their attack, while the Valkyries were at negative 034. Kill leaders, Grappato and Garbade had two apiece for Converse, and for Flagler, Dixon leading the way with four, Boyd and Berglund with three apiece. So a fairly balanced attack, as you would expect, with all the weapons that the Saints possess. Valkyries will have the serve to begin the second set. Boyd goes off speed, kept alive, good hands by Converse. Berglund with a big swing, wants it back. They'll go right side to Simmons. Simmons again, and that's up into the rafters, and that'll be a point for the Saints. Simmons really a natural outside hitter, which means playing on the left side of the attack, but because the Saints had so much depth at that side, they moved her to the right side, and she claimed that starting position a season ago. Boyd off the net and down. Might have mistimed the jump a little bit, but the result was exactly what she was hoping for. This is Danny Russo serving, number 22. Russo, a libero from Miami. Transfer from Butler. Also played at Eckerd. Didn't play at all with the Bulldogs, but did play at Eckerd in the Tampa area. And there's a finish from Bloom. Good serve from Russo. Backline attack from the Valkyries. Bump set. Simmons goes off speed, off the block and down. Nine kills and four blocks against Washburn for Simmons in that season-opening defeat for the Saints. Saints will set it up, go back to the hot hand. Lamoureux with good defense, and Boyd is there. So quick on that middle attack, Molly Boyd. Molly, the junior out of Chicago, led the team in blocks. Was third in the PBC in blocks, fifth in hitting percentage. And into the net go the Saints. Side out. Evelyn Fitz will serve. And it's a good one. Saints scrambling to keep it alive. It'll be a free ball for the Valkyries. Simmons, a standing swing, and she gets the kill. Wow. Simmons is in the zone right now. Edie Lamoureux Drops to the service line. Clamoreau led the Saints and all of the Peach Bell Conference in digs a season ago. It was fifth in aces as well in the conference. Back set, Simmons into the block, kept alive. Another swing. And up close, Bloom. Set, Bloom again, and another finish for the first year Saint. Cassidy Bloom, that gets a timeout. Saints lead it 8-1. Saints in control in their first home match of the season. First match for them in the Saints Classic. Again, five teams here, including Flagler. Each team will play the other four over the course of 2 days. I'd like to thank some of the sponsors of Flagler Athletics, including 93 King, alumni-owned two-bedroom cottage just 53 steps from campus. Applebee's, there's no place like the neighborhood. And Academy of Bus, we know the way. Through the middle it goes, and there's Robertson, who's been a bright spot for an otherwise tough day. Robertson picking up just a second kill, says the stats. Feels like more. And she floats one long for a service error. Checking back in for the Saints, Fitzpatrick and Dixon. And getting a breather are Mack and Simmons. Fitzpatrick will do the serving. Freshman from Ocala. The Saints were under the net, or into it one. About the only way Converse is able to register points is when Flagler makes a self-inflicted error. Serving for the Valkyries is Alyssa Graff. Bloom again. Ooh. Was there a touch? No. Flagler thought that one of the Valkyries got a finger on that. Instead, it's a Converse point. It's Dixon. And that was either touched or was actually in. It's a side out. Checking back in to serve for Flagler is Ella Wicker. Wicker, another freshman from Woodstock, Illinois. Back set, nice swing, dug out by Wicker. Now, Cecilia Robert off the touch.
Robert, one of the returners. Junior from San Juan, Puerto Rico. Transfer from Eckerd College. Comes from a volleyball family. And the set was a little errant. And Tori Barr couldn't get a hand on it. Saints cruising here up 12-4. Bricker gets another one. Here's Robert with another swing. And that's another point for Flagler. So essentially the second team, I would suspect, is in there, aside from Lamoureux. Good to get a lot of playing time up and down the roster. Into the block, and the Saints will not be able to return this. Here's Jasmine Hamilton serving. And the Saints quickly take the serve right back. Molly Boyd checking back in. And serving for the Saints is Gracie Fleming, a freshman from Denver. That's an error from Fleming. Kinsey Day answers with a service error. More substitutions coming for the Saints as Cameron Fenner will check in. I think this is the first we're seeing of Cameron. Also getting into the game is Jordan Norwood, who had a kill earlier. Fenner, a backup setter, serving specialist, arguably the best server on the team, along with Lamoureux. And well placed by Fenner. But the Valkyries are able to find the open spot in the defense. That's Fitz with the finish. Ariel Bryant checks back in. Graf goes to the bench. And here's the setter, Gregory, serving. Boyd from the right side. Molly Boyd with that length of hers. And when they kind of do the short set, if you will, she is very dangerous. It's tough for the defense to, and the block especially, to get prepared for a Molly Boyd attack, especially on a short set. Russo back in to serve. Robert takes a seat. Or a stand, if you will, along the bench. Here's Russo. And the attack error from Fitz. Saints up by 10. Just noticed our score bug is not working. We don't have a producer today to watch those kinds of things, so I'll try to be a little more vigilant in giving you the score. Saints lead it 1-0 and 17-7 here in the second set. On the overpass, easy for Boyd. And a timeout called by the Valkyries. Gives us a chance to thank some more of the corporate sponsors of Flagler Athletics, including Anchor Faith, the community of people passionate about Jesus, A.D. Davis Construction, builders, developers, and contractors. Bailey Group, no matter where you want to go, will help you get there. B&S Signs, quality signage and service. When it comes to signs, we do it all. Ameris Bank, savings for the expected or unexpected. Atlantic Dodge, proud supporter of Flagler Athletics. Bertroll & Company, find your home today. And Carmelo's, delivering old world quality. So a quick look at the stats through one set plus. Saints continue to hammer the ball in the attack. 480 now is their hitting percentage. The Valkyries have gotten up over zero. They're at 021, so they've improved their attack as well here in the second set. The kill leaders, Molly Boyd has 7 for the Saints, Dixon with 5, Simmons with 4, and Berglund has 3. And for Converse, 3 players with 2 kills apiece, Gropato, Garbade, and Robertson. Out of the timeout, Russo has the serve. Go back to Fitz, who's been a hot hand. Didn't get all of that one, but that off-speed delivery actually kind of worked for her. I think it threw off the block a bit. Lamro, another excellent dig. Boyd into the net for a service error, or an attack error. Lamro digs out another fastball. Here's Bloom into the block. Converse starting to show some energy, some signs of life after reeling off a couple of points in a row. It is 18-10 Saints. Again, our score bug not working. Early season wrinkles to be ironed out. Bloom handled by the Valkyries. Norwood with that southpaw swing. Converse playing better defense in the last number of sequences. And there's another point for the Valkyries. Now 18-11, Flagler with the lead. Flagler with the one set advantage. They took the first one 25-12. Good effort to keep it alive by Bryant, but she couldn't keep it on the court. Boyd takes a breather. Lamro will do the serving. And back in the match is Gracie Fleming, the freshman from Colorado. Off the net court and an ace for Edie. Big swing and the kill registered by Gropato. Valkyries have shown some life as of late, down 20-12. Maybe too late to salvage the second set, but looking to build on something as we head into the third, and it's a service error from Robertson. Constant substitutions from the Saints. Back in is Fitzpatrick, and Dixon also checks back in. pass from the Valkyries, and that was an easy one for the Saints, who now lead at 22-12 in the second set. Jump serve, and it's an error from Fitzpatrick. Saints servers have been impressive, especially some of the newcomers. Just three service errors so far, according to the live stats. Big finish from Dixon in the middle. Now with Dixon complimenting Molly Boyd in the middle, shades of what the Saints have had in years past with Boyd teaming up with Logan Garcia. Another overpass and another point for the Saints. It is set point at 24-13. Wicker will try to close it out. Back set into the block, and that'll do it. Robert and Fleming team up to put up a wall. And the Saints take set number two, 25-13. We took the first one, 25-12. We'll see if we can close out the sweep coming up. And welcome back to Flagler Gym here in St. Augustine, Florida. Match two of the Flagler Saints Classic. Embry-Riddle won its opening match against Missouri Southern. The Eagles will be back in action, I believe, in the next match. Let's see if I can track that down for you. So Cameron Fenner will begin serving. So Valkyries with a good start here as Fitz puts another one away. Back set from Fenner, who has taken over the setting duties. The finish from Stemkowski, who had a great start to the match in the first set, has been somewhat quiet. And part of that is just the Saints have played so many players that Stemkowski hasn't had as many opportunities as you might expect. Fenner, another back set for, I believe that was Fitzpatrick. That is Fitzpatrick. Amelia, the freshman, listed as a setter, attacking from the right side and finished with authority. Here's Stemkowski serving off the block. Fenner going back to Fitzpatrick. And a point for the Saints. There's a blocking error committed by Converse. Saints have tied it at 3 here in the third set. They took the first two sets by scores of 25-12 and 25-13. It really hasn't been close. Back set. Robert with a nice dig. Fenner bump sets. And a free ball coming for the Valkyries. Dumped over. Nice play by the setter, Gregory. Valkyries tie things back up at 4. Well, the second half of the second set, the Valkyries played much tougher. Rapata will do the serving. Robert, backline attack. And that one is out. No touch. Yes, it was touched by the Saints. The Saints were celebrating. They thought they had forced the side out. And instead, the Valkyries grabbed the 5-4 lead. The first lead has come in this third set. That's cross court, and that is out. So Valkyries on a bit of a run here. Remember, both clubs looking for their first win of the season. Valkyries looking for their first set win of the season. Robert out of the back row. Here's Fitzpatrick with the serve. High in the air, and the jump serve is into the net. Seven, five, Valkyries. That's out. Day just missed it. And Brooke Singleton checks in to do some serving. She's another of the serving specialists along with Lamro and Fenner. Veteran out of Kissimmee. And a double hit called against Converse. That knots things at seven. Tipped off the block and down by Tori Barr. And a service error gives it right back to Flagler. Here's Lamro. And the finish by Fitz. Valkyries tie it at eight, get the serve back. And there's an ace. Well done by the setter, Gregory. Chance for the Valkyries to set up their attack. They go through the right side. Another free ball coming. Another attack from the right. Tight to the net it goes, and into the net were the Valkyries. They'll call it a double hit officially. Tough ball to handle as Fenner gets back into the ball game. Dixon gets the breather. Well directed into the open space by Grappato. Saints had swarmed forward looking for the block, and there was an opening in the back left corner, and Grappato found it. 11-9 Valkyries. Off the slide step, and that's out. Robert on another nice finish and a well-placed swing by Grappato. And that prompts a timeout from the Saints. We'll step aside. Valkyries lead it by four here in the third set, but they trail two sets to none. out of the Saints timeout. I'd like to thank some of the sponsors of Flagler Athletics, including Vested Metals. We are a customer-centric and solution-based metal supplier, and UBS Financial. Pursue what matters most to you for today, tomorrow, and generations to come. Fitz serving. Tight to the net it goes, and another attack error. That was Fitzpatrick. Fenner did all she can to stay out of the net on a very tight pass, and the Valkyries lead it by 5. That is, just out. So the Saints get a break on the service error. Bloom checks back in. Haven't seen much of Simmons or Berglund here in the third set. Mishandled on the serve receive. Back set and big swing, Fitzpatrick. Saints climb within 3, 14 to 11. And another good attack, this time from Ariel Bryant, the freshman, gives it back to the Valkyries. Off the net cord, Lamoureux somehow fought it off. Robert from the back line. Robert has a live arm. Gracie Fleming back in. Lamoureux gets a breather. Couple of swings in a row from Bryant, and the Saints let it fall to the floor. Valkyries by 4. Lepato serving. Through Fitzpatrick again. Off speed, and that one caught the antenna. Fitzpatrick to serve. Whoa, and an ace. Beautiful serve. A high toss and then so much downward English on that ball. Saints climb within 2 in this third set, 16-14. Sorry about the problems with our scoreboard. Dumped over by number 17, Mackenzie Schmucker. She's a Florida kid. Saints were setting up for a block on the outside, and Schmucker saw that the seas had parted and dropped it right in. Through the middle for Dixon. Fitz attacks. Bloom, and there's the finish from Cassidy Bloom. Bloom has been a real bright spot among the newcomers. Singleton serves. Fitz again off the block. Kept it alive. Free ball for the Saints. Fitzpatrick will go to Robert. Fitzpatrick now tries the other side in Dixon, and that's into the rafters and a point for Flagler. Another kill for Dixon. Dixon has 7 kills now. Off speed. And it'll be a free ball coming for the Saints. Fitzpatrick on the outside. Robert off the block. Kept alive. Bumps set all the way across the court to Fitz. And that hit the rafter and fell in. Kind of unlucky for Converse there. So the Saints have climbed to within 2. Oh, no. They're going to give the point to the Valkyries. I'm not sure how that worked out. Valkyries will set up the attack. They go to Robertson. Beautifully kept alive by the Saints, and now they'll have a chance to set up an attack. Fitzpatrick all the way across to Robert, across off the block. Great point here. Dumped in. Still going. Fitz again with the swing. And finally, the Valkyries prevail in the most entertaining point of the afternoon. 19-16, Converse. Wow, the athleticism of Gracie Fleming. The set was a little out of her reach, and she was able to hang in the air and just get a finger on it and found an open spot. 19-17 Valkyries. Saints with the serve. Here's Lamoureux. Service error comes at a bad time. So Valkyries open up a 3-point lead at 20-17. And the setter, Madison Gregory, will drop to do the serving. And a service error gives it right back. Fenner will check back in to do the serving. Dixon gets a break. Fenner for Robert, handled by the defense of the Valkyries. Fenner goes the short way to, that is Stemkowski. Saints within 1, 2019. See if Fenner can dial up some of that serving magic. Big swing and the finish from Grappato. I've had a lot of confidence in that stroke. 5th will serve Valkyries 4 points away from their first set victory of the season. The Saints clinging tight, 21-19. And another service error. Russo, I think, is going to check back in to do the serving. Danny Russo. And that is the case as Robert heads to the bench. We've seen very little of Boyd or Berglund or Simmons, essentially the starting front line for the Saints, as Coach Lopez evidently trying to work out what he has behind the starters. Now the Saints have tied it at 21. Unlucky for the Valkyries that again hit the rafters. The rafters sit pretty low here in Flagler Gym. And you can play the ball off the rafters, but it obviously changes direction and speed and that type of thing. There's a point for Converse. on another confidence ring from Grappato, this time from the right side. Hamilton doing the serving, the libero. And I think that is three consecutive service errors from the Valkyries, who are looking to close this fourth set out, or third set, excuse me. Stankowski. Right through the middle it goes, and another one for Grappato, and now she'll do the serving. You think at this point the Valkyries would just want to get it in. Fenner back set. Fitzpatrick, no. And then the block is there. That's Fleming. Good set here. Tied at 23. Dixon's back in. Fenner's out. Fitzpatrick with the serve. And again, dumped in. And Bloom takes advantage. Cassidy Bloom. It is 24-23 Saints in a timeout. And we'll keep it right here.
Ladies and gentlemen, the final score of today's match is Plucker Cavendish. Oh, I'm sorry about that set point. Disregard everything I say.
So here at the Flagler Saints Classic, trying to let you know what will happen in terms of schedule. At 3 o'clock, we're expecting Embry-Riddle to play Missouri-St. Louis. St. Louis is the one ranked team in this field. Embry-Riddle defeated Missouri Southern earlier in the opening match of the tournament. So it'll be Embry-Riddle and Missouri-St. Louis at 3. Then this Converse squad will play Missouri Southern at 5. And around 7, Flagler will play St. Louis. So that's the real test for the Saints, although Embry-Riddle has given Flagler fits over the years. So that will be a good one. That will wrap up the tournament tomorrow evening. So it's match point for the Saints. Fitzpatrick. A tough set, and that'll do it. The Saints prevail 25-23. They sweep by scores of 25-12, 25-13, and 25-23. Saints pick up their first win of the season. They're now 1-3 on the campaign, and Converse drops to 0-4. Well, thanks for watching. We'll be back with the Flagler match around 7 tonight. And all the matches will be broadcast here on the PBC network. Thanks for watching, everyone. Saints win.